COVID, an epidemic devastating to both the prisoners and the guards. But now hundreds of inmates and staff are being vaccinated. The first on-site vaccinations are happening today at the G. Robert Cotton Correctional Facility. Staff members have had opportunities to get vaccinated, but this process will give them flexibility, Michigan Department of Corrections Public Information Officer Chris Gout said.
We had some staff that were, you know, not able to get it, and some staff that were able to get it. And so what we did is we worked with the state health department to secure doses for our staff population so that they could have access to the vaccine and then provide that to them on site.
Which may help stem the tide of coronavirus infection rates in the prison. Prisoners have received 620 vaccinations across the Fort Jackson facilities. All of them were 65 and over or had severe health problems.
There's about 33,000 prisoners statewide. So 4,000 out of 33,000 so far have been vaccinated.
Here in Jackson, with 5,687 prisoners and 1,509 staff members across the facilities, vaccinations are critical.
You've got MDOC employees that live out in the community and work, you know, in other areas of the community. So it's critical that, you know, being that they're one of our largest employers in our county, that they get vaccinated. So kind of twofold there in terms of protecting those within the facility, as well as protecting those as they go out and about in the community.
The Department of Corrections worked closely with the Jackson County Health Department to get shots in arms for the employees.
And we sure hope that that they take advantage of it, because we were able to secure these just for our employees to be able to take. And so whatever we don't use today in Jackson, we'll go back to the Jackson Health Department, and then they'll be able to have those available to give out to members of the community for the phase that they're currently in.
Jackson County health officials say vaccinating prisoners is important because living together in close conditions makes them particularly vulnerable to the disease.
Being that it's a congregate care facility, I liken it to, you know, we also keep track of nursing homes on a quite close basis. And, you know, there are individuals who are elderly who might be staying in the prison. So, you know, understanding that they could be at risk, they're also vulnerable. It's critically important that they be vaccinated and protected as well.
Health officials are urging both inmates and staff to get vaccinated to prevent any future outbreaks. In Jackson, Joe Gebhardt, Fox 47 News.